God bless you out there. Hello there, out there, YouTube. Christ the Spiritual Cyberspace Slam out there on YouTube in North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Middle East, Far East. A new prophecy from the throne room. A new prophecy. Prophecy on Illinois USDA food pantries. This is straight from the throne room. We're seeing some last days, perilous times. We're seeing famine in land right now. Uncle Sam's pantry is empty, but praise Jesus. Jesus' food pantry is full. Uncle Sam can't take care of the church, people, or the world. That's the church's job, the Great Commission. I pray God puts conviction on your heart. If any way you can help, least your brother in food pantry in Pinckneyville, Illinois, with your prayers or your blessings, anything, lift me up in your closet of prayer. Remember George and Betty Culley, Alicia Culley, least your brother in ministry in Pinckneyville, Illinois. This is the first time in 15 years that this month there's 70 food pantries, USDA food pantries in Illinois, in southern Illinois, that is not getting a USDA food commodity delivery. This is going to put a lot of my business. You know, I emailed two state senators in southern Illinois and four state reps, and I told them, this will cost you election if you will not help the people. They will vote their pocketbook. They will vote their stomach. They are hungry out there, and I haven't got no response. And people's going to remember you at election day. People here, we're in $4 gas is killing the people here all over the United States, just not southern Illinois. The $4 gas, you fill your car up, then your cupboard's bare. Your food cupboard is bare, is empty. We're getting more people here in least of Butter in Pinckneyville, Illinois. We had 20 new ones last week that we broke our record, and it's getting terrible. And this will put a lot of these USDA food pantries, we're missing a delivery here for a month. It's going to put a lot of my business, and it's just the beginning. I hate to say it, Bible prophecy. I'm going to read the Bible later on that what we're seeing happen here, that it won't be long. The market beast will start here. No man can't buy or sell. You can live without money. You know, you can't eat money, but you got to have food to eat. You got to have food to survive. And it won't be long. They won't be robbing you for gasoline or robbing you for money. They'll be robbing you of food. It's getting some dangerous situations here. It's prophesying the Bible. I'm going to read this real soon here. So I want you to pray with me right now. Lord Jesus Christ, this is on my heart. You know, this is close to my heart that I am not in good physical condition right now. God, but my wife has helped me with the food pantry. I can't do the work. My wife is doing it for your glory, God, and some of my volunteers. I thank you, Lord, for my volunteers and my wife to keep this food pantry going for your glory, Lord Jesus. And God, let the presence you come down on them, your presence from the crown of the head to the soles of the feet. Let thy manifold double portion, Jesus, your anointing, your Holy Ghost and fire. Let your anointing come down, and Holy Ghost and fire, and just touch your people. Thank you, Jesus, the Savior, Messiah. Thank you to God of Israel. Almighty God, we love you. We worship you. Oh, Jesus, in spirit and truth. Amen, amen. And I'm going to read the Bible right now and bring it on down, how this Bible, line on line, precept on precept, for the glory be to God here. In Jesus' name, scripture on scripture. In the Holy Bible here today, in chapter 6, in Revelation, verses 5 and 6. Now, we haven't seen the food prices yet. Now, this is the worst, even worse than the 1936 Dust Bowl famine in Illinois, over the United States of America. When they start hitting the food chain, the corn crops wiped out here 90 to 100%. You're going to see even worse than the Dust Bowl in the midst of the Depression. And right now, I don't know what's going on in Washington, D.C. I don't know why USDA is not making deliveries. What's happening here? Maybe Congress didn't get the farm bill. Maybe it's broke. Maybe it took the USDA food commodities out of it. You know, they don't have money to deliver the food. We're in a dangerous situation here. So I'm reading out Holy Bible, Revelation chapter 6, verses 5 and 6. And when he had opened the third seal, I heard the third beast say, "Come and see," and behold, and lo, a black horse, and he that sat on him had a pair of balances in his hand. And I heard a voice in the midst of the four beasts say, "A measure of wheat for a penny, and three measures of barley for a penny, and see thou hurt not the oil and the wine." Right now, that prophecy is right there, the third horse of the four horses of the apocalypse right there. That is the famine in the land. And what we're seeing right now, a loaf of bread, a name brand bread costs $4 a loaf right now. And when this prophecy happens, might not be too far down the road here, a loaf of bread will cost you a day wages. You'll see a day in the United States, America, and the world, a loaf of bread will cost you probably $65. And not too far down the road, this is some well-fetched idea. This is from the Bible, God's holy prophecy. I'm going to tell you, four state senators in Southern Illinois, you two state legislators, you better respond to this, because this will cost you election. People are hungry. What we're going to see in Southern Illinois, United States of America, there'll be blood in the streets. People will be rioting. They won't have no food in the cupboards. They're being hungry here. And you're going to see martial law here not too far down the road. Get off your blessed insurance, you state, two state senators in Southern Illinois and over in Illinois, and you four Southern Illinois state reps. And Congress, get off your blessed insurance. This is not a Republican. This is not a Democrat issue. This is a people's issue. And the people go remember you at the ballot box. Remember this. They'll vote their stomach. When their stomach's ground, when their stomach's empty, they'll vote their pocketbook. If you don't help the people's going to remember on election day. That's a little words of wisdom and counsel from the throne room today. So if you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, this is your time. Time is just about running out. See, I got me a new watch today, and we're on God's time clock. We're on Jesus' stopwatch. This is, the Lord's time. The God of Israel, Jesus the Savior and the Messiah time. And my foot is on the rock. That is the rock of Israel. That is the rock of all ages. You know, that is the solid rock of Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ told Peter, and he said, "On this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail." So this is your time to turn your life over to Jesus Christ. You know, the hard times are coming. The famines are coming. You're going to see a black Christmas in Illinois, over the United States, America, the world. It's going to be a 2012 black Christmas, because there's going to be famine in the land. There's going to be food on the food shelf, but the people won't be able to buy it. They'll be so high. There'll be highway robbery prices. You don't have to worry about $8 gas. You know, if we have war with Iran, you know, United States or Israel had war with Syria, it's going to be a high food price. Besides the high gas prices, that's going to really wipe out this economy over the world. So say this prayer with me today. Turn your life over to Jesus Christ before the really bad times come. There'll be a time come if you don't accept Jesus Christ in the easy way. Now, there'll be a day someday somebody come to your house with a gun and say, "You know Jesus Christ." If you say yes, they'll shoot you, or they'll come chop your head off. You know, it won't be long. It's coming down the road. You know, martial law's on the horizon. Dying martyr Christ for Jesus Christ on the horizon. Happened in third world countries. And the last place it happened in the United States of America. It won't be long. Say this prayer with me. Confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ will forgive you for your sins and save your soul. Lord Jesus Christ, I am a sinner. I come to your amazing grace, your throne room of grace today. Oh, Lord Jesus Christ, forgive me for my sin. Lord Jesus Christ, thank you for saving my soul. Lord Jesus Christ, thank you for writing my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Oh, Lord Jesus Christ, I thank you today. Give Jesus the best hand clap. You just accepted Jesus Christ, your personal Savior. It'll be your greatest decision in your life. It's priceless. All the money in the world can't buy it. You can't earn it. Freely received, freely given. And now you're a witness. Email George and Betty Culley's channel on YouTube. and tell us you accepted Jesus Christ your personal Savior. Or write us, or our address is on the profile, and give a witness that Jesus did a miracle today. You're a walking miracle. You're born again. And for God's glory, we would worship and praise and thank Jesus and give him all the praise, honor, glory for your conversion today in Jesus' holy name. I thank Jesus for you all. Me and Betty love you all. Alicia, keep praying for us, and it won't be long. Keep your eyes on the eastern sky. Jesus returning soon. He's just about over with. I told a man yesterday, I'm an old street preacher. He didn't know Jesus Christ. And he said, I'm not ready. I said, son, I'm going to tell you one thing. You can forget me. I'm nobody. But don't forget Jesus. You know, remember that name of Jesus. Someday, every knee will bow, every tongue confess. Jesus Christ is Lord. And let the power of God fall on you, anointing, Holy Ghost, and fire. Touch him from the crown of your head to soles of feet, Lord Jesus. Let thy mantle fall. A double portion on you, and you born again people, give him strength for your glory, your mercy, your grace, your peace, your joy, unspeakable for glory. Oh, the joy of the Lord is our strength. That's where we live, for the glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, amen. We love y'all, but most important, Jesus Christ, King of kings and Lord of lords, the Savior and Messiah, loves you. Amen, amen.